up and down and in and out, and he's adjusted with players in different positions all over the place this year. He's had a terrific job.
Blomqvist centers right onto the stick of Maroon. The puck not frozen by Nedeljkovic, and finally he's able to smother it. Carlson, 1,000th career game with three different teams, Ottawa, San Jose, and now the Penguins. In his first year, a free puck came right to Brian Rust. It's still free and centered by Crosby, but they couldn't carry him in. From St. Ivan, he got knocked off the puck. Mike Sullivan has the two rookies out there killing this penalty. Here's Pasternak back for McAvoy. High slot, rebound, and that one might have hit the goal post. Coach Danton Heinen at Denver. Jim won a national championship behind the Pioneer bench in 2017. Pasternak hit the post again, and the Karen came off the back of Nedeljkovic, and then Riley Smith fanned on it as he came moving down the slot. Boston 3-on-2, but not a lot of gas in the tag after the effort in their own zone. Here's Peek, the trailer, out in front, hoping for a tip, and they score! Jammed in by Jake DeBrusk at the net front. And Boston has a 1-0 lead.
Offensively, DeBrusk's got his 19th of the year. Andrew Peek throws this to the front of the net. As you see, Pettersson and Riley Smith vacate the front of the net. DeBrusk is going to get in front of Raquel and punch this through the legs of Nedeljkovic as the Bruins get the first goal again. That's good
news.
Going
to be a factor in the race to win the Stanley Cup in the postseason. They'll need a lot more out of him.
Yeah, that's good news for them, though, isn't it? Another forward that can punch some goals in.
Now Grzelcyk, rebound, score! Pavel Zacha! And just like that, it's 2-0.
Pressed of Nedeljkovic as he comes into the middle of the ice, and this puck bounces past Bo Joseph way out into the slot. And Zach is just going to the front of the net, and he makes a terrific finish. He beats Nedeljkovic over the glove. A loose rebound, one he won't like.
At 8:22.
Now what a chore against a really good Bruins team with a goaltender playing really well.
Here's O'Connor with some room. Out in front of the score! Tipped in by Brian Rust.
Favorite players is Brian Rust because of the way that he plays the game. Simple, straight ahead. The way that Sidney Crosby likes it to be played. If you're playing on this line, you have to play fast and direct. Drew O'Connor has grown into this. This is a terrific play from O'Connor. He uses size and strength to go down the boards. A terrific skater. And Brian Rust. And that line has carried the Penguins. Rust, 7 goals in 11 games. And of course, Crosby's just been incredible since the middle of the March.
Pasternak has Heinen out in front of the net. Goes to Shattenkirk. He scores! Kevin Shattenkirk with the wrister in the top left corner. And Boston back to a 2-goal lead.
950 is on the board. Pasternak's hit 2 goal posts, and he makes a terrific play. Bing and in. Right through the seam. The Shattenkirk shot beats Nedeljkovic over the shoulder, and the Bruins quickly back to that 2-goal lead on Kevin Shattenkirk's goal.
Carlson will be up high. Crosby on the faceoff. Controlled by Charlie Coyle of Boston. And Lindholm for Coyle, who directed it in. Tristan Jarry on in relief of Alex Nedeljkovic. Didn't look like Carlson saw it coming, so the Bruins picked it up. Marchand scores! A shorthanded goal! The crowd can't believe it. It's as if Carlson didn't know the puck was nearby. The Bruins said, thank you, we'll take it.
Balls on the air, and this misplay from Jarry and Carlson. I think Carlson thinks there's another forward there. He saw the puck, I think, Sean, and didn't really react to it because he thinks he's got help coming on the boards. But Marchand goes to the forehand. That's the first shot Tristan Jarry has faced.
Wow.
It's in the net. And a stunning fake deep to the forehand, and it's in the net.
Malkin centers for Bunting, and they score! Tipped in at the top of the crease. A power play goal for Pittsburgh. And they're back within two. They had been 0-for-12.
Feels like a must-have, and Michael Bunting, who's done a terrific job since coming over in the trade for Jake Guentzel, is standing right on the blue paint where he's been most of the night, and you'll see this puck squeak between the post and the pants of Ullmark as Bunting just pushes himself out into a little bit of a passing spot from a couple of feet. Bunting's on the board again, and it's now 4-2.
He's been a nice addition. There was a lot of angst here, and understandably so. Pasternak established the zone. Ricochets back to the line. McAvoy wanted to once time it, but it wasn't in a good spot for him. Eller sends it ahead for O'Connor. Making a move through Marchand. Drew O'Connor scores! A shorthanded goal for Pittsburgh! Oh, there is going to be a penalty on Boston as well. If O'Connor had not scored.
Turnover by McAvoy in the offensive zone. That puck has to go deep. When it doesn't, O'Connor recognizes that Brad Marchand's the only defender back. He pushes it by Marchand, uses his size and speed, and scores him.
Here's Frederick. Loco. Centers one, and Geeky scores! Morgan Geeky, a huge goal for Boston. They're back up by two with 5:50 to go.
Make a terrific play. Frederick will roll this around the boards, and as Shea goes to the puck, he doesn't deny the pass. Or well, actually, he just misses it. He doesn't quite get there in time, and Geeky, who's had a tremendous year in his first year in Boston, not qualified in the summer from Seattle, makes it five.
Crosby couldn't get it in deep. Zacha got in the way under 3 minutes to go. Boston leading 5-3. Net empty. Extra attacker on. Carlson lost the puck. It's free for Danton Heinen. Empty net. Goal! Danton Heinen, the former Penguin, delivers a huge blow to the playoff hopes of his former team.
That'll do it for today. There's not anywhere to go along the blue line. Carlson's trying to dance there to keep the play alive. Heinen makes the defensive play to poke it over the Pasternak, dead center for Danton.
You're still in it, and it's going to be hard to shake that tonight. This is a tough loss.
Yes, indeed. Bunting scores. They're not dead yet tonight. Michael Bunting. His second goal of the game in 16 games, but Bunting's been excellent as a Penguin.
Strong play by Raquel, gets around the outside to Bunting in the slot, and Bunting will one-time this over the glove of... Oh.
Yeah, he's capable.
Yep.
Just frustratingly inconsistent for Bruins fans. Here's Pasternak. Jari's back in. Killed the goalie shot. Stopped by Jari at the buzzer. And a fitting end of the night for Pasternak.